Hi guys, today we are going to look at LALR parser, LALR one parser. Why all the time we are telling one parser is one symbol we are considering. Follow, in the SLR one we were considering follow. One we will be looking ahead, that is a meaning called one symbol. This is the grammar we started looking into in the previous session. S produces CC, C produces small c, capital C. This is terminal followed by non-terminal. These both are non-terminals. C produces D. That you should remember. Just for convenience, I am computing first of all the non-terminals, S dash, SC. I may use very few, I may not use very few. That is fine. But I am computing for the given grammar, complete first computation, S dash, actually we suppose not to do, it is not at all required, S dash, because it is newly included symbol. Whatever the given production, yes, this is a starting symbol. If you look at the starting symbol of this production, it is a capital C. Then it is not possible to collect or harvest the first symbol, so we need to take a next step, capital C. We are looking into this production, small c would become your first symbol. Then one more production, this small d would become your next symbol. Then capital C, first symbol, first of capital C. Just for capital S, we have visited C. So no need to think and analyze. Just copy paste this first for C as well. Our very primary step for the LALR parser is, we need to bring augmented grammar. One new symbol we need to include. For that, we need to assign the starting symbol. S dash produces S. So this is a new symbol. We are assigning the starting symbol of the given production. This is the original production in which the starting symbol is S. So next, rest of all the productions we are keeping as such. No more modification. Then for the original production, we need to number it. Number one, number two, number three. We are numbering it. That is the second step. So augmented production and this. After this, what we need to do? We are going for canonical set computation. Canonical set computation, all the time we used to start with I naught. Now, in the case of LALR, you would be going for second component computation. That is the new thing we are looking into this parser. What is second component computation? I'll explain. Nothing to worry about it, but this is the new concept we are bringing in into LALR than SLR. So the second component computation is new concept. Please pay your attention at least for a couple of cells in this table. Now what we are doing, as usual for the SLR, how we did the augmented production, we started placing the dot operator in the beginning of the production. That is a usual mechanism or usual method. Now comma followed by dollar. For the augmented production, it is mandatory to do like this. What is the mean mandatory? This is the algorithm somebody proposed, somebody invented, somebody thought of it, or somebody scientifically proved, and it is implemented, and it has been taken into consideration for the practical scenario as well. So we are not inventing. We are just following somebody's invention. Then we need to understand appropriately. There is no rule like that. So, but somebody invented the brain, how that particular person thought of it. We also need to think in the same direction in order to become successful with that parsing action. So that is the purpose. We need to follow what exactly that particular inventor did it. So what is that invention is? Look at this. Dot S followed by second component. This is the kind of invention for LALR. This dollar, why we are including? There are several parser we have seen. Operator precedence parser, LLR parser, shift reduce parser, SLR parser, SLR of zero parser, SLR of one parser. These are the parsers we have so far come across, in which you would have noticed all the time stack is loaded with a dollar, input buffer is loaded at the end dollar. Stack is initial push symbol to the stack is dollar, input buffer end symbol is dollar. That is a matching. Dollar dollar matching or the tag is indicated as an accept state. That is the reason we are including this dollar symbol. Instead of dollar, you can include any other symbol also. But for theoretically, we are considering now dollar traditionally. I studied this compiler design in 1999. 20 years, the same textbook, the same dollar symbol is carried out. So next, dot followed by capital S. This capital S, since it is non-terminal, we need to bring all its derivative production. That is the indication. So, yes, what are all the productions starting with S? We need to bring it here. Yes produces dot CC. We need to place dot operator. As usual, after writing the production, we need to place a dot operator. How to compute this dollar? Second component. That is the trick we need to learn now. So there is a general rule for this. Now let us see the general rule. Look at this general rule. Second component computation general rule. Let us consider the rule of its computation. Say for example, this is a production. A produces alpha. Alpha means it can be anything. Terminal, non-terminal. Symbolic representation we are giving, that's all. Alpha dot capital B beta comma A comma B. ARP or A comma B. Look at after dot, there is a non-terminal B so that we are bringing all its production dot gamma, something like that. Now, how to compute first is the question you will ask. First computation dot followed by capital B, because of that we did this all. After the dot symbol, rest all we need to copy or rest all we need to think in our mind and we need to compute first for this. Remember guys, this is the rule. This is what important and you need to focus here. This is new concept you are learning today. So this is applicable for all the productions. See, look at dot followed by capital B. B we should not bother. Dot followed by whatever the symbol we should not consider. Rest of all the component we need to include, including that comma or remove the comma, write as such. Remove comma, write as such. So this is what the pattern. So in which whatever comes first, that is what your first. This is the part you need to copy paste. That's all. This is the thumb rule. Understand guys, if you have got doubt, you can clarify. Otherwise, I proceed. Look at here. Dot, yes. After dot, remove comma. What is available? Only dollar. First of dollar, what would become? Dollar. That is the reason dollar is written. See, here we need to compute first of dollar. Why we are computing first of dollar? Dot followed by whatever is available, that should not be considered by you. Because that is for, if it is terminal, we don't bring any more new production. If it is non-terminal, we bring new production. That's all. That is as usual concept like what we discussed in SLR. Right now, we are in the role of computing second component. In order to compute the second component, after this S symbol or dot followed by whatever is available, exclude that. The remaining all you need to harvest, in which comma don't have any meaning. Comma is not at all an operator. For human understanding, we are placing this comma. So that first of dollar only left out. I have written dollar here. Now, coming to the next level, dot is the operator followed by capital C, non-terminal. So because of non-terminal, I need to bring all the productions associated with C. There are two productions associated with C. So that I'm bringing capital C produces small cc, capital C produces small d. After that, we need to place dot operator in the beginning of the production. In both of the productions, the first symbol is terminal. So no more other productions we need to bring, we can stop the job. So that is fine. Now how to compute the second component for this? Because of this first component, first dollar, I have got this. Now I need to compute the second component for this. So how to compute? Let us see. So first off, first C I need to leave. I should not consider first C. Remaining all I need to copy paste. Remaining all I need to consider for first computation. Let it be. So I'll remove. So after the first C, I need to consider remaining all. Now try to compute first of C. What is available? CRD. That is what I have written here. CRD. Hope so you would be understanding why I have put CRD here. Now, similarly, because of this statement, we got this. Now I need to get this. How I am getting? I need to do the same job. First off, copy paste. Dot followed by small c, we need to forget. Remaining all only I need to consider for the first computation. Let me forget this small c. For this, I need to compute first. Just now we have computed first of c. What have come? CRD. See, already we have done CRD. So the same is applicable for this production as well, so that we have written CRD. That's all. This is the way, or this is the rule. This is the rule we need to remember all the time for the first computation. Now let us move on to the second step. Now we need to shift the dot operators. That is what our role. Next. Shifting the dot operator is a next duty. For that, a new canonical set I am creating. That canonical set I am labeling it as I1. Now what we need to do? See, dot is available here. We need to collect all the combinations of dot S in the I naught set. We have only one dot S combination. This dot need to be shifted left of S to right of S, so that we are doing shifting operation. See, dot has come from the left to right. Second component, no more modification. We need to write down whatever is available. The same second component we need to write down, because no more computation we are considering that. Otherwise you compute. Now when we can compute, if there is one more production only, we can compute the second component. We don't have any production, only one production. Whatever is attached with that, the original production before shifting, whatever is attached as a second component, the same we need to copy paste. That's all. Now we are going for I2, next canonical set. For that, dot C is the combination we are going to consider. Guys, am I audible? Dot C is the combination we are going to consider for the next step. So this dot C combination, we need to cross this dot next to the C. After the first C, we need to cross. See, the dot is shifted or crossed next to the first C. The remaining C dollar. Now, how we need to do this step? Let us compute first for this. See, dot followed by C we should not consider at all. After that, what is left out? Comma and dollar. Comma is not our operator. So we are writing first of dollar. So first of dollar would become dollar only. That's all dollar. That's why dollar has come. Now look at dot followed by small c. We should not consider. We need to do after the dot c, we need to do next. This first of dollar we have brought here, dollar. Next we need to do for first of c dollar. 1 minute, I will check it out. Yeah, C comma D has come. Closure, only dollar has come. Dollar, dollar. We are into which state? 0, 1, 2, third state only. This is available. Okay, let us see. Now, first of C dollar. Dot C we should not consider. The remaining we need to write down. That remaining all we need to write down. First of C we need to write. So first of C would become no dollar. CD only will become first of C comma dollar. Because dot followed by what is available, that symbol we should not consider. Remaining all we need to write down. So the remaining all would become C and dollar. For that we need to compute first. When we do the computation first of C, then it would dot comma C comma D. This is the step number I2. Next I3. For I3, what we supposed to do? This dot need to be shifted to this after this small. So let us do that. The next role is I3. I3 computation, we need to work on this production. C produces this production. So we need to work on here. This dot need to be shifted next to the small c. Now dot followed by capital C. So that I need to bring all the productions associated with capital C. These are all the productions. Next, as usual, we need to place this dot operator in the beginning of the production, in the beginning of the production. Now, comma, we need to do second component computation. How to do second component computation? Dot followed by C. We should forget about it. Next, we need to compute first off. Dot followed by C, if we forget, the remaining would become CRD only. First of CRD would become CRD. So that I need to write the same CRD as a second component. Next, for this, if we compute first, dot followed by small c, we need to forget. Rest all the symbol we need to consider. For the first computation, I need to forget this small c. So if we compute first for this combination, also it produces CRD. That's all. So that now I3 is completed. We need to move on to I4. I4 is the next state. What we are going to do? We started with this production C dot. Let us see what our other production. C dot is over. Left out production is only this. So we need to consider for the shifting operation. I need to shift this dot next to the D. The second component, nothing need to be bothered. Because second component, what is the original? The same we need to consider. The same second component only we are going to consider. Now, I5 computation. So next, canonical set. Now I naught, whatever was there, that entire I naught we are done. Now I naught, there are four production, 1, 2, 3, 4, all the four we are done. We need to move to I1, nothing more we are having to do. It is having only one production. Among that also, that dot reached end of the production, so nothing to do. Let us consider I2. When we consider I2, we see this kind of combinations. Not first and all, it is not required here afterwards. We need to look at only this. Now look at, these are all the productions or combinations we are looking at. We need to consider the first. In the first production, dot capital C pattern. There is no more production has that pattern. So I need to work on only on this production. I am doing this pasting here. This dot operator need to be shifted here. Dot has reached at the end of the production. No more work. So we can feel comfortable because no second component computation also required, because it has only one production. In that one production also, dot has reached at the end. So now we need to go for, this is I5. Now we need to go for I6 computation. So this I6 computation, we started with I1. Remember where we started, I1, then we moved on to I2. I2 one production we are done. We need to do second production. Dot C pattern is available. We need to consider the dot C pattern. Only one production is available in that form. So I need to consider this production. I need to shift this operator, dot operator. So I'm shifting the first symbol, small c. So this is shifted. Now we need to go for I7 computation. For what I need to do I7, we stopped at I2. This is a production just now we have considered for the shifting operation. Now there is one more production available. I need to consider that. If I consider this, I need to shift this dot operator, shifting to the last. There is no more symbol followed by dot, so I need to stop. There is a problem here. See, I didn't do this. Dot followed by capital C, I need to bring all the derivatives of the production capital C, small c dot capital C. See, already we have done this, so that I no need to do once again. Instead, I can copy paste this. The same, look at. Now I need to mark. This is what we are going to look at later on. I6, I3. I3 and I6 are similar. Anyway, we did procedural phase, but it is similar, I3 comma I6. So now last production of I2 we are done. Now our duty is to do I8. We need to compute I8 canonical set. When we are trying to compute I8, we need to look at what else is left out. I2 we are done. Just now we visited. Let us look at I3. In this I3, we need to consider this production. Small c dot capital C. There is no other production, so that I need to consider this only one. I'm taking here, I put it here, I shift the dot operator next to the capital C. There is no more duty, we should feel happy because capital C followed by dot, it has reached at the end. So no more duty for us. Small c, capital C, dot. So we can stop it. So next, let me know. I don't know. Just I'm writing I9. How many are required? I don't know. I9. So let us go back and let us revisit. All the productions need to reach, the dot operator need to reach at the end. Until then, we need to work on. So which is the production we have considered? Dot C we have considered. The next production, this we need to work on now. This dot need to be shifted right to the small c. So I need to consider this production. This dot I need to shift to the next level. Let us see, is there any combination available? C dot C, the second component is changing. Look at the C comma C or D. Here it is different component. Here it is different component. So we need to compute. So when I am computing this, I need to consider save dot C followed by, these are all the two productions I need to consider. From the original also I can compute, but it's a convenience, it is available, I am working on it, that's all. So now because of this C, this production we have brought and placed the dot, let us not worry about this first right now. Then because of this dot C, we have brought this production and placed the dot. Now how to compute this first? See, this is dot followed by capital C, we need to ignore. The rest of the component is what? C or D only. So that first of C or D, what would become? C or D. First of C or D would become C or D. So that it is written. Look at the second production. So this dot followed by small c, we need to forget. We no need to bother. Then rest all C comma C or D. So if I compute first of C, already we know it is C or D only. So that it is written. So our duty is over now. Let us see what else we need to do. I10. After I10, we need to go back. Where we stopped, we need to proceed further. We stopped at this combination, small c dot c crd. It is here, small c dot c crd. This we have processed. Let us look at the next one, small cc crd followed by crd c dot. See, the same combination only we did right now, so we no need to bother. We can stop. So C produces dot C CRD. Yeah, the same combination available already. D dot CRD. So we can stop. Now let us look at this. S produces CC dot. Already dot has reached at the end. We can stop. Next, C produces C dot C dollar. This combination nowhere available. Look at. Nowhere available. So we need to consider right now. See, this combination is with CD. Dollar combination we don't have. So that I need to work on it. I'm carrying here. This dot is shifted to the next level. After that, after dot, there is no more symbol available. So we can stop it. So we are done. Whether I11 is required, let us work it on. After this, dollar over. This small c, if I shift, this already available. Then small dot d shift already available. Dot d crd already available. See, i4 i7 combination. We need to pair it. i4 i7. Because these are all repetition. Just for the flow I have computed. i4 i7. Next symbol we let us consider. This is over. Dot we reached at the end. Dot we reached at the end. C dot C comma CRD. But let us see, is there anything available? C dot C comma CRD. Small C. Yeah, it is available. C dot CRD. So I3, I6, I9 is also going to become same. I9, I3, I6, I9. So, lot of repetitions. Because step by step we have considered. Because sequentially we are working, we can't look at the things parallelly because of this table manner. So I3, I6, I9. So no need of computation. Everything we are done. So CC dollar is available. CC CD is available. DCD is available. CC dollar. CC capital CC dollar is available. DCD available. All the productions from the original or augmented production. The dot has reached at the end. Ultimately, we need to consider the dot which we placed in the production in the beginning, whether it has reached at the end or not. That is what we need to consider. It has reached. So we can stop it. Now let us look into the holistic picture of the computation. This is the augmented grammar. This is the production. Step by step I have seen. This I have taken from the internet. We are going to look at this. S dash produces dot S dollar. So second component dollar we started. Dot C, because of dot S, all the productions we have brought. Dot CC, comma dollar. Totally how many states are available? It has only 5 and 6 state. Rest all repetition states so that it is rewritten. Look at repetition states. That is why I have collected here. Repetition states. This repetition states, they are not giving any new state. They are writing, just writing that same repetition state number. That's all. Now look at dot CC dollar. C produces dot small c CD. How this dollar has come? Dot followed by S, we should not consider. Rest all we need to collect and compute the first. So it has come. Dot capital C we should not consider. Rest all we need to collect and compute first of C. So that C dot D, CRD has come. Dot followed by small c we should not consider. Rest all we need to harvest, compute the first. So first of C would become CD. That's perfect. Now this dot need to be shifted. 1 minute, I'll take one digital pen for pointing. So that where I am showing, you will have the focus. Look at this dot is shifted here. Whatever I did, only summary report like I am telling. Nothing more I am doing. This is sequential manner we discussed. Now parallelly we are looking at. So now this dot is shifted here. Dollar, no more work because it is only one production, so no more work. Next, this production we have done, completed. We need to work on this production, dot CC. So that S produces C dot C, dollar. Dot followed by this C we should ignore. The remaining we should collect, dollar only. So that first of dollar, what would become? Dollar. Next, because of this dot C, we are bringing all the other productions of C. Dot small c, capital C, dollar. These two productions, dot is placed. Dot C, we need to forget. Remaining all we need to consider, we need to do first computation. It's supposed to be here. See, CRD is supposed to be. I don't know why this website or this author have written dollar. This is the only mistake. Rest all right. Here, it should become CRD instead dollar, because this is the logic we are using. Dot followed by whatever is available, that we need to ignore. Rest all we need to combine and find out the first. So first of C comma dollar would become first of C. First of C is what? CRD. So that is how we need to work on. So next, otherwise I will work it out. We have done, no, with the same combination we can go ahead. Next, Second component, we no need to worry. See, they have combined immediately. All the first component only we need to consider. First component of these all productions we need to consider. Only then with that we can go proceeding rest all. See, whenever the first component is repeated, we need to combine that states. All the productions are combined here. That is the reason 3 is written, no other combination. Similarly, D dot, whatever the first component is similar, we need to combine all together. In the table, whatever I have written, the similar manner only they are doing, then finally combining. Then C, C dot, whatever the first component we need to retain, the second component we no need to worry, the entirety we need to combine together. Similarly, we need based on this first component, we are combining. That is the meaning I'm trying to say. Based on the first component, this also has been combined. This is the first computation we started with. Now we need to go for next step is table construction. As we discussed in the previous session, what are all the components should be in the table? In general, it should be state, all the unique states. So based on this table canonical set computation, the number of unique states are 0 to 6, totally 7 states. Then it should have two different components as we have seen in the SLR parser. Action table, go to table. Action table should have all the terminal symbols. Go to table should have all the non-terminal symbols. That's all. Normally, we don't consider this augmented symbol they have put here. So because of implementation, so they were considering the totally it is a kind of animation or it's a kind of interactive software. If you go and look at that website, I will copy paste in the chat window after a few minutes. So if you give a string here, it will parse and it will give you. That is the beauty. But you can't change the production. That is a sad part, or I don't know. You can try here. You can give the different production and try it. So I tried with the different input only and clicked this button parse. Then it will give the parsing action. Step by step, how theoretically we are discussing the similar manner, it will give us the output. It will give the tree as well. Parse tree as well. See, only the lines are missing. See, this kind of lines only missing. Rest all are same. So that is the beauty of this link. Now action table is filled with all the terminals. We have only two terminals, small c, small d. Additional, the special terminal which we have included is dollar. All the go to table will have kind of non-terminals, capital S, capital C, that's all. Now, similar we only we need to work on. What is the beauty is, all the set without bothering the second component, we have combined together. See, look at everywhere the combined. Rest all would become the same. 1 minute. Shift action, accept action would become the same. This reduction action is based on follow computation again. Look at guys, how to understand whether it is follow computation or not is, see, in this row, all the symbols are available with reduction action. In this row, all the symbols are available with reduction action. These two rows. This row, if you look at, only one reduction action, only for dollar symbol is available. It is not filled with all the cells in this row. That is the reason I'm telling we need to work for follow also. We need to compute follow for this filling the table. First computation is useful for this, the second component. This follow is useful for filling this reduction action. Whenever the dot is reached at the end of the production, for those we need to find out follow symbol. For the follow symbol, we need to write down the reduction action. We have three productions. Three production, one is S. There are two productions with C. That is the reason two rows are entered with reduce action. We have only one production with S, so that it is entered with R1. If you compute follow, reduce action, you can understand. Rest all would become same. Same shift action, same accept action, same this go to non-terminal, upon non-terminal where it goes, it is going to become same. With that, I am concluding today. For the same LALR, I would be doing one more problem. After that, we are going for CLR parser. The moment CLR parser is completed, we are done with unit 3. I'll give you the link for this animation, LALR. So you just have a look at glance of this website today itself, so that you can able to understand or you can able to see the simulation. So I have shared in the chat window that animated, it is not animation, it's a computation. It's a kind of educational software. It is not a real parser as well. So how the teacher is teaching, for that it is a software implemented. There is a production, it will construct the table and it will does all the canonical set computation, and immediately it will consider the input, or else we can change the input. I think that also it don't permit, doesn't permit, I think so. So it takes one input and parses on that input using the table. So that kind of dynamics they have applied. So that is the purpose of settling